Hi everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to fetch data from MySQL database using Node JS and Postman. So let's get started. So for this we need to install two libraries. They are MySQL and Express. So just go to your folder in Visual Studio Code and type npm I express space MySQL and just hit enter. So once the packages are installed, just go to your folder and create a file. Okay, it's going to be main.js. And just hit enter. So as usual, we will begin by importing. So it's going to be const express equal to require express, and let me just copy this and paste it. It's going to be const MySQL equal to require MySQL as well, and it's next line const app equal to express. Just the standard stuff, okay, in node programming. And just come to the next line, and now we will be creating our connection variable for MySQL. So let const con be my connection variable equal to MySQL. So this variable should be coming over here dot create connection. Just open circular bracket and curly bracket. So here we will be specifying host, user, password and database details. So first let me go with host colon over here. So by default the host is going to be localhost, as I am using my local MySQL. Okay, so it's local host, and next one is going to be the user. So here you specify your username that you are having in your MySQL workbench. So here I am having root, so you need to specify whatever username that you are having over here. So I will just give it as root, and next is the password. Same corresponds to password as well. It's going to be unique for you, okay, for that particular user that you are having. So let me just type out my password over here. That's fine. And next is the database. So you need to specify only the existing database, okay. So for this, let me go to my MySQL workbench. Let me go into my connection. Yeah, so here I'm having some standard SQL codes, okay. So this is the database that I am going to use here. So it's MySQL node. So let me just copy this and now paste it over here. Yeah, that's fine. So this is basically our connection variable. And in the next line, we are going to give our connection variable, which is con.connect. And this will take a callback function, okay. So it's going to be error and arrow function over here. So in case if there is any error, let's just console that error. So it's going to be console.log error, and if there isn't any error, which means that the else block will be getting executed. So it's else. Let's just do a console.log connected. Yeah, I think this is good for now. Next thing is we will be basically writing our query to fetch the data from our MySQL database. So just come to the next line. It's going to be app.get. We'll be using the get function over here as we're going to fetch the data. So just open circular bracket, and here you will be specifying the path. Let me put a slash and I will just name it as fetch. You can name whatever you want, and just come out of it. Another callback function. It's going to be request comma response arrow function over here. And here we need to specify the query. So for that we will be using our connection variable name. So it's con dot query. We will be having this query function, and just open circular bracket, and within this we need to specify our query. So this query that I'm going to write over here is going to be same as what we are having in our MySQL workbench. So let me just copy this as well. And you can also have this query in a variable, and then you can just assign your variable. You can like do however you want, both are same. Since it's like a very small query, I'm directly like having it inside my query function itself. You can do like however you want. So once you're done with our query, let me just put a comma over here. It will also have a callback function. So just put function. So it will have like three parameters. One is error, another one is result, and another one is going to be fields. Yeah, fields, I guess. Yeah, and just open curly bracket. So here we will be basically using only the error and fields, okay. So if any error, same thing, we are just going to console.log that error. And basically all the data, that is this data from our MySQL workbench, will be present inside this result. So we can either console or like send that result as a response to our Postman. It will be appearing over here. So I will go with both the options. I will show you both. So I'll just put a else and I'll do response dot send the result. And that's it. Now we are good with our fetch function over here. And the final thing, we need to like start our server, make it listen. So it's going to be app dot listen. And I'm going with port 3000. You can like give any free port that you are having. So comma and another callback function. Okay, I'm tired of typing. Let me just copy this. Yeah. So error means, yeah, instead of response, I will just do console.log on port 3000. Yeah, I think now we are good. So now what we can do is we can just go and create our database and our table. Okay, this table name should be present inside this particular database. Okay, you have to be like really, really careful with that. So let me go to my MySQL workbench. So first let me create this database, MySQL node. This should be same. So I'm just creating this database now. Yeah, it has been created. So if I refresh it, yeah, here it is. So now let me just create a table. Before creating a table, we need to use that particular database. So just use MySQL node. And I'm having like a really, really simple command over here. Just creating a table with two columns, ID and name, running it. Yeah, so this table name should come over here. My table, that's what I have named. My table, it should be coming over here. Be careful with the letters, okay? And next thing, let me just insert some values. So just insert it. Let me just change it to as 2B and insert it again. C as well. Yeah, we just insert it. Yeah, that's fine. So now let me just display the values. So these values should be appearing in our Postman now, that is over here. So if this works fine, that's the proof. Yeah. So now let me just go to my code and start the node server. So for starting the node server, it's like simple. Just go to your terminal, node your file .js file name. So mine is main.js. Just hit enter. So here you can see I'm getting on port 3000 as well as connected. So which means that I don't have any errors over here. Next important thing, just go to Postman. And you need to like do some changes over here. You need to just go to this particular path. So it's fetch, and you should not have any data that is being sent. And another most important thing, you need to change it over here because we are performing get operation. Here you need to change it as get as well. Super important thing, because you won't be able to find this mistake that you have done. Okay, really important to change it here as well. So now I will just go and click send. So here you can see I am getting all the data 1A, 2B, 3C, which is present in my table over here. And now let me also show you how you can like basically access this data, because I think it is now inside a object format. So in order to show you like why it is in object format, let me just now console it instead of sending it. I will comment it and I will just do console.log result. All right. Stopping it, control C to stop. Restarting it again. Yeah, now if I just go to my Postman and again send it. So this time we won't be getting any value over here, and instead we will be having a value inside our console, because I'm just consoling it. I'm not sending the value. Yeah, I've commented the send, I'm just consoling it. So this is what I told you earlier. You'll be getting in a form of an object. Okay. So how to convert this to a list or a JSON format is, what you're doing is just come here. Okay. Inside your console.log, it's going to be JSON all in caps dot parse open circular bracket again that caps JSON dot stringify, and within circular bracket you need to pass result. All right. Yeah, now I'm saving it, stopping it, control C again, I'm restarting it, again sending it. Yeah, so this time you can see I'm not getting in this object format. And if you want to like access individual values, what you can do is you can like store this in a variable. So instead of directly like assigning, let me just now cut it out, and I will have a variable where r equal to, let me just assign everything. And if I just now go and put r of 0, and let me just copy this, paste it. If I do r of 1 dot name, okay, so if this works fine, we need to get this thing id name as output for this first console, and we need to get b as the output for second console. Just basic list manipulation, list accessing. Okay, that's easy, I guess. So now let me just restart it again. Okay, I need to save it. Control S, save it, and again restarting it. Yeah, sending it again. Yeah, so here you can see I'm getting the output perfectly. R of 0 corresponds to the first value present inside our list, and this, okay, this corresponds to second item, and I'm accessing the name, which is B here. So this is working perfectly, I guess, and I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also done many other programming videos in Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, as well as C, C++, Java, Python, Blender, SQL queries as well. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.